Hey guys, it's Evie. Let's talk about the amazing concept of crowdfunding. These days, anyone with a unique, cool, or crazy idea can raise a ton of money very quickly. A recent high-tech, high-heel shoe campaign raised $1.8 million. The Exploding Kitten card game raised almost $9 million. And then there was the guy who raised over $55,000 just to make potato salad. These successful campaigns are awesome, but are they really that important? I recently learned the hard way about what was truly important and what is not. My little sister Sadie recently passed away from a type of cancer called rhabdomyosarcoma. I miss her every single second of every single day. I was thinking of ways that I could honor her, and I thought of something she said in an interview with the Truth 365. Here it is.
I think that when everybody comes together, that would be great because there are so many brilliant minds out there, and once you give them a job, tell them what they need to do, they can make something amazing, such as a cure to childhood cancer.
This gave me an idea for a crowdfunding campaign in order to make Sadie's dream come true. The good news is that I know some brilliant minds at Dana Farber Cancer Institute in Boston who are working on new ways to kill rhabdo cells without hurting the child. Take a listen.
One of the new technologies that we've been able to harness here that didn't exist years ago, even 2 years ago, allows us to systematically delete every gene in the genome so that we can identify which particular ones cause specific death of rhabdomyosarcoma cells with really limited toxicity to any other tissue. We're going after those specific genes, the ones that when you delete them, are completely toxic to the cancer cell. And we've identified a preliminary map in just a few cell lines that has shown us that we have about 100, 150 of these particular genes. Targeting those, initially using genetic engineering and with a goal of getting to a point where we can use a drug to target those, is exactly the purpose of this project.
So what is holding these researchers back? What's slowing down their progress? Children with cancer do not have time on their side.
We see every day on the clinical side and also on the research side progress being made in this disease, and it simply can't be done without good funding for projects focused on this disease.
This funding is particularly important because it helps us prioritize rhabdomyosarcoma research. Rhabdomyosarcoma research, like a lot of pediatric solid tumor research, often doesn't receive that much funding and priority. And so with this funding, we're hopeful that we'll be able to make discoveries in rhabdomyosarcoma that will lead to new therapies to make the lives of these kids and their families and communities better.
And I think it's important for everybody to know that our commitment to identifying a new drug treatment that is less toxic for these patients so that they can live their lives out in the community and go to school and have fun with their friends and play sports, all of that is tempered by funding.
Yes, that's right. The lack of funding is a major roadblock, but this is where I think crowdfunding can help. In my opinion, I think the lives of children are far more important than most crowdfunding campaigns out there. On a scale of 1 to 10, I think potato salad is a 1 and my sister a 10. Will you help us by donating to our campaign today? Our initial goal is $50,000, but we would love to raise a little more. No amount is too small. And if you can't donate, please share this video with your friends. As Sadie said, if we come together, we can help the brilliant minds find a cure to childhood cancer. You have an important role in this campaign's success, and we appreciate your help. On behalf of my family, I'd like to thank you.